Meantime, a new CBS poll finds that 70% of Americans do favor DACA. 62% of Republicans say they would approve a deal on DACA on the Dreamers in exchange for funding the border wall. Joining us now is Great America PAC chairman and Kelly Ward campaign chair, former Reagan chief White House political advisor, Fox News contributor Ed Rollins. That's an awful lot.
I know. What I most appreciate, you didn't say I'm almost 75, which I appreciate that. So,
what do you mean? Again, over the weekend, it was now David Perdue saying, the senator saying that Trump never said that. President Trump has to come out and say, I'm not a racist, but there's some indications.
I don't like it, and she's the words expert, so I don't like it when people say I am not something. Mm-hmm. I go back to Nixon who I served. I'm not a crook. I'm not a liar. I'm not a harasser. I'm not a racist. It's much better to say I'm a leader and prove that you're a leader if you're the president.
That's right.
And this president is not careful with words, and he needs to be much more careful about words, either when he's tweeting or when he's basically speaking. And I wasn't there. I don't know what he did, but now to be in an accusation with the people that are in that room, Durbin and others, when you need them to basically move anything forward, it's just not a good way to be. So I think DACA needs to be put aside. I think a federal judge, and I usually don't applaud any federal judge from the West Coast. I think a federal judge has given us a little time on DACA. We have a very important issue to get done, and that's this budget. If we go through another continuing resolution, we put big, big impact on our military. That in itself, without DACA or anything else involved in it, is a very, very difficult task to get that accomplished. Immigration reform with DACA and the wall and security and all the rest of it is complicated, and it'll take time and needs to be focused on by itself and not with the threat of shutting down the government.
How do you think it plays out? Because, again, they need to come to some sort of resolution on the budget or come to some deal by the end of this week.
I don't think they can in this mood, in this environment. I think they'll do another continuing resolution, whether it's for a week or a month or whatever. The reality is, if it was just purely budget, in which you have to lift the caps in order to increase the Pentagon spending, and obviously the offset to that is increasing domestic spending, is enough of a battle in itself. But I think shutting the government down in January, which we've never done before, will be devastating for both parties. The country is disgusted with all politicians from the president on down. And I think getting into this environment, fighting over whether you're going to shut the government down and what your reasons are, is just, you need to go behind closed doors. You need to work this thing out, take whatever time it takes, whether it's a week or 2 weeks, and get it done and come forth with a unified. Republicans have to understand, even though they have the majority in the House, the Senate majority is really not there. And I think at this point in time, it's 51-49 with John McCain probably not capable of being able to come back. And obviously our senator from Mississippi, Cochran, not being well either. So the reality is you don't have a majority and you need 60 votes. So this is the most important thing. All these members that are up, and there's eight Republicans who are up Senate. There's 25 of theirs. I think they want to get something done so the country will basically think they can work.
Well, I want to point out that you're campaign chair for the Kelly Ward for Senate campaign in Arizona. And on Friday, the Republican candidate wrote an op-ed in AZ Central, which reads in part, "When I am elected to the Senate in November, I will get to work immediately on a wall, not DACA policy, to keep our country safe and our citizens prosperous." Your take on this, because she still has to win the nomination, and you've got Congresswoman McSally along with Joe Arpaio running for the nomination.
First of all, I'm a volunteer in this race, and I admire Kelly, and I'm going to do everything I can to help her, as I do a lot of other candidates as a volunteer. I think the critical thing here is those are her statements, those are her feelings, and obviously the wall was very symbolic for President Trump, and it's still very symbolic, and if you basically don't do something where they're 39%, whatever the number is, think that they're trying to get that security, and the wall being the symbol of that security, you're going to see a lot of people walking away. Arizona is a very conservative state in the Republican primary, and I think at the end of the day, Kelly Ward is doing what she thinks is right and what she believes.
Does she disavow Bannon, Steve Bannon?
She was never. I think everybody basically is sort of irritated by Bannon's inappropriate use of words in that book, and I think to a certain extent he's not an asset anymore. So she has talked about there's a lot of people that endorsed her, and Bannon was not the first I was one of the first with my PAC, and I don't think Bannon's going to play much of a role in the campaign.
So, and let me ask you a political question about DACA immigration reform. We heard the president saying, you know, do Democrats, do they want a solution or do they want an issue? What is your view about this from between now and the midterm? Are Democrats going to work together? They do have a constituency that they promised they were going to get some, you know, that they were going to work on DACA, but now they have an issue that they can beat Republicans up with.
Well, I think your points are very valid. DACA has become a political issue above and beyond the human value of bringing these people and letting these people stay. The other side of it, though, is you can't, you know, I think the chain immigration and the fact, where do you stop? As part of an immigration package, a big package, when you still got 11 or 12 million people here, and I think we really need, we've not done a bill since 1986. I was in the White House when that was occurring. Very complicated and took a long time. I think this DACA thing, again, I go back to the judge, has given us some time. And I think these issues do need to go to the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court wants to decide once and for all, do executive orders really matter, and what are the powers of the presidency? And the quicker that happens, the better it'll be. But I don't think the court is going to take DACA up for the foreseeable future, and that gives them some time to resolve some of these issues.
And we know they have time because the government is now allowing, and this happened in the last few days, allowing renewals of the DACA Dreamer application.
Other than the sword hanging over these people's heads, and I think from a human perspective, you've got to be concerned about that. But equally as important, we do need a big immigration reform package in which security becomes foremost. What happened to us in 86 is we basically, about 5 million illegals, 2.5 million of them got legalized and took advantage of it. But the security side was never implemented. And so we basically, instead of never having to worry about it again, it became a very severe problem. So I think we have to basically, whether it's a wall or other things that appease the security conscious people, it has to be done, it has to be done quickly.
And I'll just point out that agreement that was reached in the Senate that was presented in front of President Trump only had $1.6 billion toward a border security, a border fence, and that's about one-tenth of what he wanted.
And equally important, that was not a Senate. That was people who decided they're going
to put
a bill together in the Gang of Eight at one point in time. No one's come forth and said, here's a bill that 60 senators are going to vote for.
Correct.
That's what's needed. And when someone does that, and I would argue that, you know, the president got a lot of play last week from his meeting with about the TV, and that's not negotiation. I've worked with the Congress for a long time. You got to do that behind the scenes. You got to make sure all the players are in the room, and you got to make sure that basically you move it forward. Then you bring it to the president. The president's the court of last resort, and he should basically, these are my parameters. Perfect example was the Martin Luther King holiday, which Ronald Reagan signed off on. Very contentious, very hard to get through. He made the final decision to sign off on it. A lot of debate, but it was behind the scenes. It wasn't out front. And I think to a certain extent, America benefited immeasurably by that. And I think to a certain extent, America could benefit immeasurably by a legitimate immigration bill.
Thank you, Ed.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Ed Rollins, again, one of my favorite people
on the
planet.
Thank you.